Okay, so I am here with my Epson F1070. This is a DTF and DTG printer. I have not printed on it in probably about 3 weeks. So let's see how this goes. Okay, so I do have a little warning on this top screen up here that says shaking the ink is needed. Shake the ink supply unit which is displayed. The only one that it's showing me is white. So I will show you that in just a second. So what I'm gonna do is over here, pull the white ink cartridge out and I'm just gonna shake. If you're not sure how to shake, there's actually a how-to option on the display so you can watch a little video. So I'm just going to show you this before I click OK. Oh, now it's going. It automatically went to printer is operating. Okay, so we're going to let it do its thing. It's then going to probably say that it wants to do a cleaning, and then I will print something and we're going to see how it comes out. Again, this has been sitting for about 3 weeks. Okay, it's telling me shaking the ink is necessary, which we already did that, but maybe we need to do it again. I guess we'll see. Okay, and now it's saying it's ready. Now my guess is that if I go maintenance cleaning, it's going to do its next maintenance cleaning on the next print. So let's get something that we can print. Okay, I grabbed a PNG from So Fancy and I just threw it into Garment Creator. And as you can see, I have some DTF film in here. Now, when I went to print, as predicted, it said it needs to clean. This takes about 10 minutes. So I'm going to let this go. And then I will show you exactly once it starts printing. Now, I will say, I apologize for like kind of the casualness of this video, if you will, just moving the camera around, but I really didn't want to over edit it because I want you to see in real time, if possible, what you can do. Now, 10 minutes is 10 minutes and it went through a cleaning process, but here is where it starts printing, and I am going to leave this in real time so that you can see this. So this is probably maybe a 6x6 size DTF design that we're printing. It has mostly black and then like a little bit of color, but it is definitely not a solid design. However, what you're going to see is that the big question is going to be the white. So white ink in DTF printers traditionally is the one that's going to give you trouble if you're going to have trouble with the clogged lines or nozzles, anything like that. It's almost always going to be white first. And after 3 weeks of sitting, pretty much any other DTF printer is going to have trouble printing white. We definitely would need to do, some tests. So as you know, this one did do its self-cleaning. You saw, took about 10 minutes. Now here is the test. It's going to put the white over top the rest of that design. So let's watch this. I also apologize that the reflection on this, just due to how it has this kind of encasing, clear encasing, it's just impossible to get it so that there's just no reflection and also record at the same time. So apologies for that, but I think you get the point here that the white is not having any type of problem. So I didn't waste any film, I didn't waste any time, I didn't waste any ink or material trying to, you know, get this going. So if you are looking for a DTF printer that you're not going to print on every single day and that is going to have really easy maintenance, the Epson F1070 is a really good option. And again, this is not just DTF but also DTG, so it's really a dual printer that you can do both with. This print is now done. That was real time. Real time printing CMYK and then real time printing the white layer over top. I am not fast forwarding this. I am not speeding this video up intentionally because I did want you to see how long it took to print that. And then what you're gonna see here is me opening this and we're gonna check the other side. That is crazy. I have not printed in 3 weeks. I do not have another DTF printer that would do that without some pretty significant cleaning. So here's that print again. I actually already cured it, powdered and cured it. So it is ready to go. I can just put this onto a garment or a leather journal or even wood if I wanted. So if you guys are looking for more information about the F1070, more, I have setup videos. I have other things, other video tutorials for you. They're all in the description below. I will link to those in the description. Also, if you're looking for one-on-one help, personalized support, same day support, I offer all of that through Silhouette U, not just for, Silhouette, but also for DTF, including the Epson F1070 for sublimation, for rolling, anything that you see on my channel. I offer personalized same day support. You can get 50% off your first joiner fee with the code YouTube. Again, all of that information is also in the description below. If you're looking for the best bundles, if you're looking for where to get supplies, if you're looking for, again, more information, everything is where you expect to find it. Description below. What do you think? Are you going to look at the F1070? Is this something that is going to be useful in your small shop or even in your home? Let me know what you think. Leave a comment and don't forget to subscribe.